Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Botania, Garden of Glass. And in today's episode, what we are doing is we're going to be continuing on that mob farm and also having a look at how our Terra Shatterer is going. So let's go check out the Terra Shatterer for now. By the way, I haven't actually been playing on the Botania world too much. In fact, I haven't been playing Minecraft too much, despite getting a video up every day now. It's by the way, I've been going... Oh, what's going on here? Do I remember taking this block out? It was probably even on a video that I did this. Alright, so yeah, I always get distracted. Now, I've been putting up a video every day for, I think, 3 weeks, which is a pretty big achievement for me. Pretty big achievement. I'm really loving getting more stuff out there. I've got a vanilla series, for those of you guys who don't know. So I've been playing this, playing vanilla, and overall, it's actually been surprisingly easy to get a video out every week. It was one of my goals for a long time to get it to, like, be a thing, a video a day. And it's actually really, really awesome getting a video out a day. It's a really cool achievement. So, yeah, aside from that, I also go to university, by the way, if you guys didn't know. So I've been working at my job, doing this and going to university. So I've had a pretty jam-packed couple of weeks, but I love it. I love doing this stuff the most. Now, over here, we've got pretty much no mana, and that's a good sign, because that means it's pretty much all going into this. I think the portal to Elfheim is switched off right now. Can we sit through here? I think sometimes that looking through mana glass might mess it up. Pretty sure that's off. Let's glide down. No, it's on. Right, let's check along this last, because I don't think this will get enough mana. Although it might, but that looks like it's slowly decreasing. So, as I say, bear in mind, nothing might have even changed on this thing. It's been pretty much no time at all spent on here, so let's check it out. Yep, still rank A. What I think will be kind of cool is, in a very, very near episode, we can add some more mana stuff. More mana generation stuff. And that is working. Cool. To our base. That would be really, really useful. Another thing, with this... Oh, around here. There was that the suggestion that I was talking about in the comments about us putting dominant sparks in here. It also entailed us getting rid of this recessive and just having this as a normal spark. So what would happen is all of those would pull into there. And when they all pull into there, all of those would grab it from there. So that makes sense. It means that we won't have this, it's kind of like a one-way valve. It'll come in, won't go out. So that's a good idea. So what we can do is we can take that out. Damn it, I just missed it. we'll be lazy and wait for it because, yeah, let's get it out. There you go. And you can tell I've been playing too much in creative when I try and do stuff like that. So I don't know if this is in range. Let's check it out. If not, we can always just grab a dominant spark off there. Over there. By the way, for those of you guys who don't know, or might know, the Botania add-on pack, botanical add-ons, the one of the people who make that, Y-Sigil, had a bit of information to tell us about the villagers, and that is in regard to how they are bred using the Cocoon of Caprice. So the way that they work is apparently they've got a 1 in 20 chance. Well, if you put 20, I'm going to get this wrong. So if you put 20 emeralds in them, that gives you a 100% chance. And if you put 19 emeralds, it gives you a 19 in 20 chance. So basically, every emerald you're putting in, you're getting a 5% chance better of getting a villager, if that makes sense. So if I gave all those guys 19 and we had 20 villagers, we should expect 19 villagers, most probably, and one something else. One something else. Okay, so I think that will work there, what we've just done. I don't know whether or not they'll pull over to the other side properly. That could be something to check out. So that could be something interesting. If not, we can always maybe see if we can pull it into the middle and see what happens there. That's not too important right now. What is important right now is checking this out, and before we check this out, I want to see if I can find my, what is it, a prismatic, rod of the prismatic lake. So we go here, I'm ready. On that, that should be enough, there it is there. Cool, is this my, yeah, it's not the invisible one, that's okay. Does it come up as a separate one, the invisible one on here? No, it comes up as that. Yeah. The other one might be in my botanist's, don't know what's going on, my botanist's tool belt. And by the way, you can see why I am doing this, is because, well, that's spawnable there. Apparently nothing spawned all of a sudden, that's great. F7, you are spawnable. And I think that's pretty much it. Yep. Now, make sure our villager's still doing his thing. He is. And then, I guess we can maybe give this a little bit of a test. Maybe. Or maybe we can go for separating something else out. So we've done the spiders in there. We've done the zombies with that, which we're not too sure whether they work or not, but they might. Then after this, we got the skellies and the creepers. Now, creepers should be... Oh, well, we've got witches as well, but as far as I can see, there's no real easy way of doing that. I have to maybe see if the height thing will work on them. I'm not too sure whether the height thing will work on them. I've been thinking about it. I don't know what to do. But let me know if you guys have got an idea with the witches, because the witches are a funny one. A very funny one. But yeah, so let's sleep this off. Although, we don't have to, but we can. That cobblestone has been generating for ages. We're not going to have a cobblestone problem for quite some time now. Is this... It's still going. Yeah. I had to fix it up. I was getting cobblestone in my inventory like we had with the wooden logs the other day. So, there we go. Make sure everything's cool up here. Nothing crazy up here. Yep. Good. And that should all work. What? You missed me, buddy. Point blank. How did he spawn? Oh, that's how he spawned. let me get rid of this now, quick. Now, one issue is this. If you have a look... by the way, I swear I go faster upstream than I do in... without water. There we go. So you can see, as I come here, I stop. So what I'm thinking might be a good idea is to take out those two blocks and put these two over there. Then, if that's the case... Actually, do I even need these in here? Let's give it a go without these in here. Because I don't think I actually need them in, considering we are pushing mobs off there with water. They should go, I would imagine. I would imagine. I mean, although, when does anything I do end up working? First time, at least. So, whoop, bam, down, get pushed in here. Drop down here. If I'm a zombie, I'm like, oh my gosh, fall down there. If I'm anything else, I should, hopefully, carry on. We can always get this to be 100% by tweaking a few things and doing a few magical things, but yeah. So we're going to have the water coming here. It's going to push down. All of these are going to drop. I'm going to have to work out a way of getting creepers. Maybe, actually, a lot of the mob farms that I've seen, the mob sorting farms, have kind of pushed, had a cat or something to... shoot the creeper off that way. I'm not too sure whether creepers are scared of cats in 1.7.10, but I mean, if they are, that's great. Now, if they aren't, I mean, we're going to have to just use the tiger's eye, which I don't think was working for me in creative. So, let's have a look. Where is it there? It's not too expensive to make, so we might just give that a go. I think we want to separate the creepers first. I think that'll be a good thing to do first, and then the skeletons should just be left to be by themselves. Endermen, by the way, are going to get collected by Viniculotus, so they know Biggie, and when the water hits them, they teleport off anyway. The other ones, the witches, and that's it. The baby zombies might be a bit of an odd one. I don't think they've caused us any grief just yet, but they might. They might with that spider thing, and they also, I think actually, they'll probably do really well there, because they just run off like at 100 miles an hour, and they could actually work quite well there. So, I'm going to gather up maybe a few things, get ourselves a tiger's eye. Why is that not exit? There we go. Get ourselves a tiger's eye. And then we can see how we go with that. Alrighty, now we are back. I've done not too much. I've made ourselves... Let me just do this. I've made ourselves a tiger's eye, and I mean, that's just what we need eventually. I might as well actually do this while I'm at it. Bam, done. Now what we've got is we've got this little capture chamber here for testing. So this will be where the zombies will hopefully come. You can see that there is where we are. There's a villager. Hopefully when the zombies pop down here, can I get on here? They'll walk, run over there, fall into there, and we're going to have a bit of water right around here. And that should push into there. Now, we have to put a sign there, so I'm glad I did that, because I actually forgot about that. So, do we have wood for a sign? We do. We really do. No, we don't want that. We want that. That. And let's make it a good number. So, there. And, no, yes, thank you. Bye. There. So, we got ourselves our sign over there, which is that correct? No, we want it maybe over here. Yeah, that's correct. Good. And then we'll want the same over here. Actually, I don't know if this will be... This might even just make it lengthwise for water traveling. No, it just doesn't. So we can... Oh, I'm floating. I was wondering why I wasn't going forward. So, bam. Creepers, skeletons, and witches should go in there. We might want to make ourselves a spider viewing section a bit better. What's this here? That's our random block. There. So there's our spiders. I mean, everything here, by the way, it's temporary. We're not actually going to have all these blocks here in the end. But they will be here for now. So that's just what's happening. The zombies, we might actually need to take that row out. I think we might have a problem. It might even be a benefit. That's worth trying. It's definitely worth trying. But for now, let's switch this off. So we go down here. Bam. Now that should, yep, be switched off. And we'll wait around here. Now just watch. Can we hear anything? Is anything happening? Let's wait around. Yeah. okay, let's just keep waiting. Give it a few more seconds. And now we'll push the button. I think something would have spawned by now. It's so awkward when there's no sound. okay, let's wait. Let's see what happens. Go up here. Okay, so we've got a skeleton. Got a creeper. Hopefully they don't hit me. Yeah, they're gonna... Yeah, you know what's happening there is the skeletons are seeing me. They're not seeing the... They're not just carrying on with the stream. What's that guy doing? Oh, man. Yep, yeah, I saw that coming. Oh, man. Oh, man. Well, why are there more... Is that a flame bow? What? Okay, let's have a look in here. They shouldn't be spawning. So they're getting jammed up a bit, which is alright. I mean, we can deal with that. No guys down here, which is also a very good sign. Now what should be happening is... Oh, spider go for skeleton. Oh man, he's got his buddies on him as well. Look at that. Oh, the skeleton made it. Oh man, look at you. Aren't you a big boy? And the spideys can come back out again. So there, that's a problem. Although, it's not the biggest of problems. Because when we get them to drop down the hallway, that might be something that won't be too much of a trouble. He's just trying to find me. That's all he's trying to do. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to try this again. We're going to fix what that goddamn skeleton creeper thing did to us. He's drowning. Yeah, drown. Although, this also won't be a problem for the fact that... A lot of this will not happen because I'm not in the equation. I'm not here busy. Thought that villager was a skeleton with leather armor. No, it's not. So that should be alright. We push F7, double check. I'm going to just go away and let these despawn because that's probably the smarter thing to do. I really don't feel like a creeper incident. We'll wait this off. I might make another tweak, and then we'll be back. All right, I think it's time for test number two. I have made a few changes here. Let's quickly just show you what's been changed. We've extended this out one block, so we got three blocks, which means that over there, that water was flowing that way. Now it's flowing diagonally. Also, we have maybe... What else have we done? We've done that, fixed that little area up. That's actually about it. So that's something that has happened. And here's something which we are very lucky we had F7 on for. Now let's just push the button. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be enough, hopefully. Let's see how many we get. We should have got a few at least, surely. So we'll come here. I don't think we will be in the line of sight. There we go. There's a skelly. He just does his thing, goes past. The zombie doesn't seem interested in the villager, so we'll have to check that out. There's probably still one or two more things coming out here, I hope. Did I put a block open at the bottom of that villager? That's a question which needs an answer. Alright. Got another block there. Okay, now let's try it. Does the zombie look interested in that villager? I don't know. Now, where are my blocks? There are my blocks. And there. There. We'll go down again. And give it another try. So, button. And we'll wait. This thing's looking really, really ugly. Any ideas? Let me know. I've got no clue. In fact, there is something. It looks a bit like a ghast from a mile away, but probably not now anymore. So there we go. We can hear a spider. This is a zombie. He's not tracking towards a villager. There they are. You know what that is? That's probably the roof. Because look, those guys are running. And I think the skelly might be tracking towards me as well. Is that right? Yeah. Okay, I'll make some changes. Alright, time for another test. So we've done those changes, and I think they won't work. Alright, let's give this a go. Let's see what happens. Now, what I think is the problem, perhaps, is the fact that these guys, the zombies, I'm not seeing the block in front of them, so we might have to fix that up soon. Two creepies. Nothing else. Three creepers. And you've gone the wrong way. Was it trying to track towards me? Yeah, I think so. I think the fact that it was trying to avoid that water was probably because it was going towards me. Maybe I'll just move back. Let's just go back here. I know I don't have to do this, but this is the way I'm doing it. So we'll go all the way to there. And that should hopefully be enough. Just spam the hell out of it. And now let's give it another go. So, push button. Wait a few seconds. And hope for the best. Please give me some zombies and skellies and all those glorious things. There we go. Now, let's check what happens. There's a spider. So, zombie, not interested. Next zombie, somewhat interested. Probably gonna get pushed off. Yep, pushed off by the creepers. Now, that guy, he does seem kind of interested, but that's not interested enough for me. So, maybe we can try giving a trap door at the bottom there. That could be a useful thing to have. Look at him. Oh, he might actually get really close to hurting that guy. Because I think there's an open block there. And that could be something which might be a problem. That's alright, we've got other villagers. I really don't feel like doing it, but if we had to, we have to. Now, what was the plan? Trapdoors. Trapdoor. In like this. Oh, not like that. Like, drop. Drop. Oh, you know what the problem is? That's the problem. Got a creeper there, so we gotta be super careful. There, there, there. Let me out, please. No, what is going on? I guess that's what you get for doing a terrible mess of blocks. Okay, now let's give us another go. So, jump down the bottom. We're probably going to have quite a few mobs now, so after this we'll probably have to clear it to get some spawns. So, wait around. Waiting, and bam! We've got it. Now, let's check what happens. Let's see what's going on here. We should be far back enough. We've got some spiders there. It's a good thing. They're all jumping around doing their thing. Let's check what comes. If anything, zombie. Yeah, okay. Okay, that's good. That's alright. We've got a good run so far, but that guy doesn't seem interested at all. Skeletons are going. Zombies are definitely pulling towards that villager. We might have to find a better way of doing this with the zombies. Because that is not going to work the way it's going right now. It's not going to be a very good... What's going on with that spider? Yeah, this is not going to be a very good way of getting an accurate amount of zombies and stuff. But I think we should just soldier on, keep it going, and work out the kinks as we get going. Because that's definitely an improvement. So, let's get on with the creepers. Okay, and I'm back. I have also gone ahead and built a new, ugly, disgusting chamber for us to see whether or not we are getting creepers and skeletons getting split up. So there's our creeper one, and that is... I mean, that's alright. It probably goes with the whole theme of ugly build that I've been going for. Over there, that's where the skellies are going to get caught. And I think it's about time we give this... Actually, before we do, we have to put this down. Silly me. Now, where would be a good spot? So, and we would need the water in there. Man, I'm not doing too well, am I? Oh, there. That was almost the end of my flight. Now, we're going to put the water in there. And the way this works, let's just quickly have another look. Because I haven't seemed to be able to get this tiger's eye to work for me. So, it's a known fact that creepers are terrified of cats. The tiger's eye exploits that very weakness by emitting a feline aura, petrifying any nearby creepers, preventing them from exploding. It also has the effect of making them run away from players. And that's it. That's all it's telling us. So, I don't know. Maybe, it should be running away from me, but perhaps this could now cause a bit of problem with both blocks being there. Let me show you there. You can see that there's two mana glass there. I don't know. It could just be because I've been trying it in creative, and that might have been messing me around. As I say, I'm clueless. I'm really clueless on this topic. So what we can do is give this a good old test, like so. And that was the chamber where those others fell down. Let's just do a quick test, make sure things can get through, so we'll go through ourselves. And we jump down here. So things go, fall down there. I've got to fix that other thing up. Spiders go there. We all go down here. Zombies would go here, but we don't need to go to zombies. And I've got one block missing there, which might cause a bit of a problem. This is where the creepers should run, and this is where the skellies should go. So, I think that is more or less everything that we need for now. So, let's give this another go and see how this goes. So, jump down there. Oh, no. Please give that back. There we go. Now. Oh, yeah. And button. Thank you. Stand up here. Give it a few seconds. A few seconds. There you go. Now button. And we want to stand over here. Now the reason we want to be on this side of the farm is because we want to load as much stuff in our base as we can. So zombie goes. Good. Skellies go, good. I don't think we... Oh, there's a skelly. Enchanted bow session. There we go. They might have had a good enchanting session around before they came and spawned into this world. Skellies down there, that's good. That's a good sign. There's another skelly. I really would love to know if we have any creepers in there. Maybe we can do another creepy creeps. So we do that. Wait around. And wait. You know, I was just thinking what would be really awesome is a kind of, you know, the glass blocks, I think. I can't remember. I think it's... I could be really wrong. But I think it's extra utilities that gives you the one-way glass. And it's or darkened glass, sorry. And that would be really cool to have in Botania. Wink, wink, botanical add-ons. No, that would be pretty cool if we did have something like that. That would be really, really awesome. Then you could see what was going on in here without having the problem of light at the top. Although the mana glass works pretty well for you here. Go on, go in, zombie. Go. Oh, man. We'll have to work that out a little bit better. Definitely. There we go. He has fixed himself up. Although, actually, I could just put some more of those trap doors over there. And there's a creeper. Cool. Creeper. He just fell down there, didn't he? You really, really, really ruined my day, creeper. Let's do another test. and has anything fallen into the creeper hole? Over here. And here's zombies. Nothing's fallen into the creeper hole. Oh, wait. Here's the creeper hole. No, nothing. So let's go. Oh, what is going on? Here we go. Button. Flush him out. And there's the zombie going. So the zombies, I'm pretty happy with what they're currently doing. I think that could be a bit of trouble. We could even just drop them down even further, and then that wouldn't be a problem. There we go. There's a zombie there. There's a creeper. Creeper, is it coming towards me? Yeah, it's not running away. Maybe if we do this. It's, would this be a bad idea with skellies? Maybe, is this even in range? Yeah, it should be. That should be in range. If anything's ever in range, that should be it. Oh, will we make it? Yes, we made it. Now, skellies are probably going to be a bit of a trouble. Bit of a bother over here. Let's hope not. give us another go. Push button. Wait a bit. This is really repetitive, but it's a matter of, it's actually, this is probably the most weirdest project I've done in this world, at least. And it's actually quite a bit of fun, surprisingly, actually, considering we've having all these little annoying bits and pieces over here. It's a bit of fun. Let's have a look now. We're going to get hit by a skelly. We have to get hit by a skelly. If not, we can even have a look at maybe half slabbing. There's a creeper. Why is it not running away from me? There's a... Oh, three witches. Now, ain't that lucky. Any more? I don't think the creepers are going to come through, to be honest. I really don't. Maybe half slabs. Let's try more witches. So, half slabs. And we'll do it like this. So, we'll break that. And we'll do that. Now, I don't think skellies will be able to shoot me through there. Okay, nothing else is coming down. Nothing else. Come on. oh, there's a creeper in there. They'll think that... Was that a creeper in the creeper hole? It is a creeper in the creeper hole. Let's give this another... One more go. One more go, and then we'll go through doing some other things. So please work. Please work. Come on. Oh, now we didn't test out our skelly protection. Oh, man. Man. There we go. Wait, something's got to come down. We can't only have zombies. unless a lot of them are tracking me up the top there, we'll check what's in the zombie hole. There's a zombie down there. So I guess that was one that just made it through. Yeah, no, there's nothing happening. So I'll cut and I'll see what's going on. Alright, so I think it's time we can give this another test. I think we may have the reason to what is messing us around with these creepers. Another thing which is kind of annoying is, you'll see there's a zombie. And he's got a bone. How can I not... There, he's holding a bone, and what we know about these types of zombies, these holding zombies, is they don't despawn. So, when a skeleton sheds... That happens. Now, what I want to do in here is go grab us these. No, don't go there. I was in the sign placing mode of just pressing escape. That should be all right. Then we can even just do that, just to be extra cool. And go down there. Grab out our mana glass. And I can hear another zombie somewhere. So that's all right. All right, there he is, holding something as well. Yeah, two hits. Easy. Easy done. All right, now we can drop down. How did I get hurt? Okay, whatever. Now we wait. How awesome is the Garden of Glass sky? I just love looking at it. I just love seeing it. And where are the... Oh, there's no lines on there right now, but there's like these awesome lines that go across. I love them. I really do. Button. Press button. Now we go stand on our standing place, which I'm pretty sure is far enough for these things to spawn and do the thing. So we wait. Hopefully we get a creeper. Skellies, the Mana Seal creeper. Another Mana Seal creeper. Zombie. Hey, look, it separated the Mana Seal creeper. There's... Hey. Ah, it separated a skeleton and a creeper. He's definitely doing something. I mean, it looks like he's trying to run away from me. And a skeleton. yeah. So this will have to be rethought. I think this will have to be rethought. Man, that's annoying. And look at this. What a mess. Man, that's a mess. Although it's kind of cool. It's kind of awesome that we've tried it. We're trying it. But yeah, that's an eyesore. We're probably going to have to do something nice once we finish that. Like that or like this. Although, I think it's going to look great having a tower over there. Let's see what this is on. Hardly even moved. We may want to get a bit of Enderflame goodness going soon. We've got a Corbria. It's right here. This shouldn't be a problem to connect up. And that should work a charm. So what we can do is we can just connect it up with our Corbria system. Put maybe two chests to get us here. And that'll be a very easy way of getting rid of coal. And also way of getting mana. So that's an idea for the next episode. But for today, guys, I understand we haven't done too much. In fact, we have done quite a bit when you have a look at what we've actually achieved. They are very, very niggly, tough things that we are getting done today. And I think that's going to be pretty much it for today. So if you guys have got any any advice, if any of you guys have done one of these or have attempted and have figured out how to get that tiger's eye to work properly for you, let me know, please. Please definitely let me know. That'll help me so much. But yeah, I think that's going to do us for today, guys. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye, guys. Bye.